गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम स्नेहलता सामल, लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, बोस कटक. टुडे आई विल डिस्कस सम लॉसेस अकर्स इन सिंगल फेज ट्रांसफार्मर. दिस इज फ्रॉम द एनर्जी कन्वर्शन वन सब्जेक्ट, चैप्टर 3. सो हियर सी, व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ लॉसेस इन अ सिंगल फेज ट्रांसफार्मर. बिफोर गोइंग दिस, we have to know what do you mean by losses. Losses kon? Losses means the output power of a transformer is always less than the input power due to the losses in the transformer. That means the transformer input power minus the output power is equal to the losses. That means input minus output is equal to the losses. So there are various types of losses occurs in the transformer when AC supply given to the primary side of the transformer. When we give AC supply, see here, it is the core of the transformer. This one is the primary winding of the transformer. And this is the secondary winding of the transformer. When we give AC supply to the primary winding, of the transformer, there occurs some losses in the transformer. These losses are iron loss, copper loss, stray loss, and dielectric losses. So next is, see the what are the losses in the transformer. First one is iron loss, that is also known as the core losses. Second is copper, or which is also known as the ohmic losses. Next is stray losses, and last one is the dielectric losses. Again, iron or core losses is divided into two types. One is hysteresis losses and second one is the eddy current losses. Now we will discuss what is iron losses. So when electric AC supply is given to the primary side of the transformer, iron loss occurs. That means, see, when AC supply is given to the primary winding of the transformer, then there occurs alternating magnetic flux in the core. So due to this magnetic flux, there occurs iron loss in the core of the transformer. So iron loss are caused by the alternating flux in the core of the transformer. As this losses occurs in the core, it is also known as the core loss. That means, since iron loss occurs in the core of the transformer, so it is also known as the core loss of the transformer. So for calculating efficiency of the transformer, we use iron loss. So iron loss is further divided into two types. One is eddy current loss and another one is hysteresis loss. So now we will discuss what do we mean by eddy current loss. So eddy current loss kon? When an alternating magnetic field is applied to the magnetic material, an EMF is induced in the material itself according to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. Since the magnetic material is a conducting material, these EMFs circulate current within the body of the material. So that means, when an alternating current flows through the primary winding of the transformer, there occurs alternating flux in the core. So according to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, these changing flux or alternating flux create an EMF, electromotive force, in the core. So due to this current, the iron core is a conducting material. So due to this EMF, there circulates a current. See the pictures of how eddy currents or the currents flows in the iron core. See, we give AC supply to the primary winding of the transformer. This is the core of the transformer. When we give AC supply, then current flows in the primary winding of the transformer. Then due to this alternating current, there produces changing flux in the core of the transformer. So according to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, due to this changing flux, an EMF occurs in the core of the transformer. Since the core is a conducting material, then current flows in the core. This current is known as the eddy current. See how eddy current flows in the core of the transformer. Due to this eddy current, there will be a power loss, or which is known as the eddy current power loss. That is also the I square R loss, where R is the resistance of the core and current flows in the core. That eddy current loss. So I square R loss is known as the eddy current power loss or eddy current loss. As this current are not responsible for doing any useful work and it produces I square R loss in the magnetic material, it is known as the eddy current loss. Then how to minimize this eddy current loss? आमे केमते ए लॉस टा को मिनिमाइज करबा हमर एम होची हमर ट्रांसफार्मर रे जते कम लॉस करि परबा लॉस तो निश्चय हबो बट हमर एम होची आमे केमते ताको लॉस को मिनिमाइज करबा सो मिनिमाइज करबा पई आमे ट्रांसफार्मर कोर को ए जो लॉस को मिनिमाइज करिया पई एडी करंट लॉस को मिनिमाइज करिया पई आमे ट्रांसफार्मर कोर को आमे जते थिन करि परबा दैट इज थिन लैमिनेशन वी शुड मेक that core with thin lamination to avoid or to minimize the eddy current loss. See the picture again, how the core is laminated. See, the core is constructed into number of segments and each segment, this is segment 1, this is 2, and in between segment 1 and 2 there will be insulation. Similarly, between these two, there will be insulation. This is the laminated magnetic core. माने आमा transformer core केवे गोटे single solid piece न था. कहीं कि because to avoid this eddy current loss, it will be made laminated magnetic core. So to minimize eddy current loss, we should minimize the core. So the equation of eddy current loss is given by PE is the eddy current power loss, which is equal to KE BM the square T square F square V watt. So what is PE? PE is the eddy current power loss and KE is the coefficient of eddy current, which value depends upon the volume and the volume and the resistivity of the core material and the thickness of the lamination. Mane kete thick achi se core ta, that value depends upon the KE. KE is the constant. And BM is the maximum flux density in Weber per meter square. And T is the thickness of the lamination in meters. F is the frequency of reversal of magnetic field. That means F is the frequency of the magnetic reversal. Kete frequency re se magnetic reversal hochi. And V is the volume of the magnetic material in meter cube. So to avoid eddy current loss or to minimize eddy current loss, we should laminate the magnetic core. Next we will discuss about the hysteresis loss. What is hysteresis loss? This loss also occurs in the core. But how? The core of the transformer is subjected to an alternating magnetizing force, and for each cycle of EMF, a hysteresis loop is traced out. That means, jetebele amara core re alternating flux flow hochi, tale ek alternating flux thare core re any part re thare magnetize hochi, and then it will be demagnetized. So due to this magnetization and demagnetization, there occurs a loss or heat loss, which is known as the hysteresis loss. And the hysteresis loss formula PH for hysteresis power loss is equal to K eta B max 1.6 A B watt, where K eta is the proportionality constant which depends upon the volume and the quality of the material of the core. That means ame co quality material use korchu as a core, that depends upon the K eta. So jodi ame silicon steel ra used kariba core, tala amaro K eta will be minimum. So hysteresis loss will be minimum. Silicon steel ra dekha jaichi je K eta mane Selmer's hysteresis coefficient ta hochi very less. So transformer core ko generally ame silicon steel use karuche rather using iron. Next, F is the frequency of supply frequency and B max is the maximum or peak value of the flux density. M for maximum flux density, so B denotes maximum flux density. So hysteresis loss can be minimized by using silicon steel material for the construction of the core taku ame jete silicon steel material le jodi construct kariba tale ame hysteresis loss ta bahut kam paiba mane minimize hoba loss ta. So next is copper loss or ohmic loss, which is the very important loss of the transformer. See, the losses occurs due to ohmic resistance of the transformer windings. That means when we give AC supply to the primary side of the transformer, the current I1 starts flowing through the primary winding and copper losses occur in the primary winding. See here how the current flows. When we give AC supply to the primary side of the transformer, then current starts flowing, I1 flows through primary winding. So here a copper loss occurs, that is I1 square R1. So what is R1? R1 is the resistance of the primary side winding. So the losses is I1 square R1 in primary side. Next, when the transformer is loaded, that means comes to the secondary winding. This is the secondary winding of the transformer. Now it is open, so current is zero. When the transformer is loaded, current I2 starts flowing in the secondary side. When we give load to the transformer, then current I2 starts flowing. And here the resistance of winding, secondary winding, is R2. So here the copper losses is equal to I2 square R2. So total copper losses in the transformer is equal to I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2, where I1 square R1 occurs in the primary side and I2 square R2 occurs in the secondary side of the transformer. So these losses varied accordingly to the load. Mane load vary kale amara copper loss bhi vary karibo. So load sangare a copper loss jehetu vary karuchi, so copper loss is also known as the variable loss, whereas the iron loss is the constant loss because iron loss does not depends upon the load. Next, we see if the secondary side of the transformer is open, or thus if the secondary winding side is open, then the copper losses in the secondary side is zero, because if you open the secondary side, I2 is zero. So the copper losses in the secondary will be zero. So in open circuit case, the copper loss in the primary winding only occurs. There is no copper loss in the secondary side winding, because in secondary side current I2 is zero. So the copper loss varies as square of the load current, because I square, so copper losses varies as the square of the load current. Next comes how copper losses varies accordingly to the load. So at full load, the total copper loss is equal to I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2. Next, at half load, it will be half rho square into full load copper loss. Next, at 1/4 load, the copper losses is equal to 1/4 rho square into full load copper loss. Similarly, at 25% of full load, the copper losses is equal to 25/100 rho square into full load copper loss. So accordingly, when load varies, the copper losses is also varies. Next comes to the another losses, that is stray losses. So the occurrence of these losses, stray losses, is due to the presence of leakage field. That means ट्रांसफर्मर जोठि भी लीकेज ऑफ फ्लक्स अकर्स होची से जगह रे स्ट्रे लॉसेस हबो मे बी हियर सम लीकेज ऑफ फ्लक्स देन कोर पाखरे भी किछि फ्लक्स लीक हो जाउची सो से जदी लीकेज ऑफ फ्लक्स हबो से जगह रे ए स्ट्रे लॉसेस हबो बट दिस परसेंटेज ऑफ स्ट्रे लॉस आर वेरी स्मॉल एज कंपेयर्ड टू दी आयरन लॉस और कॉपर लॉस So it can be neglected. Generally, this stray losses is very minimum, so it can be neglected. Next, the last loss, which is known as the dielectric loss. See, dielectric loss occurs in the insulating material of the transformer. When a transformer, I mean insulation use karuche oil. ऑयल इंसुलेशन यूज करचे ट्रांसफार्मर कोर रे भी हमें इंसुलेशन यूज करचे जोटा कि दैट इज सॉलिड इंसुलेशन सो जो जगह रे हमर इंसुलेशन अच्छी से जगह रे हमर डाइइलेक्ट्रिक हीट लॉस होची सो व्हेन ऑयल गेट्स डिटोरिएटेड और द सॉलिड इंसुलेशन गेट्स डैमेज्ड और इट्स क्वालिटी डिक्रीजेस बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एफिशिएंसी ऑफ द ट्रांसफार्मर गेट अफेक्टेड दैट मीन्स जितेबले तुम ट्रांसफर्मर कोर रे ऑयल थाए जदि ऑयल वॉल्यूम कमी जिवो ताले सब सॉलिड पार्ट थिबो दैट विल बी गेट्स डैमेज आउ जदि सॉलिड इंसुलेशन हमर कोर रे थिबो सेटा जदि डैमेज हे जिवो ताले ट्रांसफर्मर रे लॉसेस हबो तो ए सब लॉसेस जोगुरु ट्रांसफर्मर एफिशिएंसी टा अफेक्टेड हुए एफिशिएंसी मीन्स तुमर ट्रांसफर्मर आउटपुट बाय इनपुट अफेक्टेड हबो So these losses occurs the due to these losses the quality of transformer decreases. मन transformer जेते rate रे हमको output power दे ही था ना सत्य दबानी due to this insulation damage. Next we'll discuss about these are the four losses of transformer single phase. Now comes to the efficiency of a single phase transformer. What do you mean by efficiency? Efficiency अगर हमें बुझिबा कौन हो Efficiency means the output power divided by the input power. See, the efficiency is denoted as eta. Eta is the output power divided by the input power into 100. Efficiency is always calculated in the percentage, so in 200. So just like any other electrical machine, the efficiency of a transformer can be defined as the output power divided by the input power. That means efficiency is output in kilowatts or watts divided by input in kilowatts or watts. So efficiency always output divided by the input power and that must be set a sabule kilowatt ki watt re thiba and also input is also in kilowatts or watts so transformers are the most highly efficient electrical devices mane amar dekha jae je efficiency transformer comparing to other electrical machine transformer efficiency sabutu highest Man, that means efficiency high means losses come. So generally, most of the transformer have full load efficiency between 95 to 98.5%. So next come to the method to find the efficiency of transformer in percentage. Here we'll see it. The efficiency is a power output by input. We can also write the power output here. Input is, we can write also the power output divided by, power output plus copper loss plus core loss. So output power is VI cos phi, that is power factor. So VS IS PF, that is power factor, divided by VS IS power factor, that is cos phi, plus copper losses plus core losses into 100. So efficiency of the transformer is always in kilowatts or watts while calculating the efficiency, because our losses are also in kilowatts or watts. Next comes to the losses. We also already read this, the copper losses, which is IP square RP for primary side and IS square RS plus secondary side. Now the questions from these topics are, which type of losses occurs when transformer is on no load? Second one, define eddy current losses. Third, define hysteresis losses. And fourth one, why copper losses are known as the variable losses? And the last, why the output and input power rating of a transformer are in kilowatts or watts during the calculation of efficiency? Efficiency calculate kariba pai amar transformer rating kahi kilowatt kimba watt re nauche, because amar losses bhi kilowatt or watt re thai. Sathi pai we must convert the output power rating to kilowatt. So thank you. If any doubt, you may contact in my WhatsApp number 9692030770. Thank you.
ଝିଅଟିଏ ତ ମାଟି ଆମ ସାମାଜିକ ଓ ପାରିବାରିକ ଜୀବନର ମୂଳ କଥାଟିଏ। ସେମାନେ ଆଗକୁ ଗଲେ ଆଗକୁ ଯିବ ସଂସାର। ଆମ ଝିଅମାନେ ଆଉ ପୁଅଙ୍କଠୁ ପଛରେ ନାହାନ୍ତି। ଏବେ ତ ବଦଳି ଗଲାଣି ସମୟ, ବଦଳି ଗଲାଣି ଯୁଗ। ସେଇ ଝିଅମାନଙ୍କୁ ଆହୁରି ଆଗକୁ ନେଇ ଆତ୍ମନିର୍ଭରଶୀଳ ଓ ସ୍ୱାବଲମ୍ବୀ କରିବାକୁ ଓଡ଼ିଶା ସରକାର ସୁଦକ୍ଷା ଯୋଜନାରେ ସରକାରୀ ITI ମାଧ୍ୟମରେ ସମ୍ପୂର୍ଣ୍ଣ ମାଗଣାରେ ଯୋଗାଇ ଦେଉଛନ୍ତି ସବୁପ୍ରକାର ଉତ୍କୃଷ୍ଟମାନର ବୈଷୟିକ ଜ୍ଞାନକୌଶଳର ତାଲିମ। ଏବେ ଆମ ଝିଅ ରହିବେ ସବୁଠୁ ଆଗରେ, ସବୁଠୁ ଉପରେ।
ମୁଁ ସଫଳ,
ମୁଁ କୁଶଳୀ,
ମୁଁ ସୁଦକ୍ଷା,
ଆମେ ହେଲେ ସୁଦକ୍ଷା।